Will the COVID vaccine alter your DNA or give you COVID? Today, we're talking about the top 7 COVID vaccine myths. Does the seemingly rapid development and approval of the COVID vaccines make you feel a bit hesitant about safety or effectiveness? Or have you heard suspicious or even false claims about the COVID-19 vaccines on social media or from people in your life? It's totally reasonable to be asking constructive questions with an open mind. It's important to make sure that you are informing yourself with credible information. That's why today, I'll be setting the record straight on some common questions, concerns, and myths that have emerged about the COVID-19 vaccines. Hey everyone, I'm Dr. Jordan Wagner. I'm an ER doctor, and be sure to subscribe to my channel. Ready to get into it? These are the top 7 COVID vaccine myths debunked. Myth number 1, we can't trust COVID-19 vaccines because they were rushed. False. Even though the first vaccines for COVID-19 do involve new technology and they were developed in record time, this record development time is not due to shortcuts taken by scientists. The new technology of Pfizer's and Moderna's COVID-19 vaccines is called messenger RNA, or mRNA. This is the first time this new technology is being used in a vaccine for the public. However, researchers have actually been working on mRNA vaccines for at least 3 decades. That's 30 years, hardly a quick turnaround. When COVID-19 started infecting such large amounts of the population, this was an obvious opportunity for scientists and vaccine developers to use this new technology. The companies then put their vaccines through vigorous clinical trials involving about 73,000 individuals between the two vaccines, and I bet most people didn't know that they also studied it in mice and monkeys at the same time. In the US, the Food and Drug Administration requires the vaccine makers to follow up with volunteers for up to 2 years after receiving the vaccines to make sure that they are safe and effective. And because of how prevalent COVID-19 is, it only took a few months for the clinical trials to collect enough data to make an initial evaluation. Myth number 2, the vaccine will give me COVID-19. The fact of the matter is, vaccines prime your immune system to recognize and fight off disease. Contrary to popular belief, they don't actually cause an infection. Again, coming back to the mRNA technology that I mentioned earlier, when the mRNA enters our cells, it basically instructs them to make a piece of the spike protein that's present on the coronavirus that causes COVID-19. Those protein pieces don't actually harm your body. They do trigger your immune system to mount a response to fight them off and develop both a T-cell and B-cell response, causing long-term memory. Myth 3, there are severe side effects of the COVID-19 vaccines. Every individual's side effects may vary. For instance, I've received both doses of the Pfizer COVID vaccine and only ever experienced a little bit of soreness in my arm where they gave me the shot. If you'd like to see the video of me receiving the vaccine and discussing my side effects, I'll put it in the link below. As I was saying, about 15% of people who received the vaccine developed short-lived symptoms at the site of the injection. 50% developed systemic reactions like headache, chills, fatigue, muscle pain, or fever lasting for about a day or two. Keep in mind that these side effects are indicators that your immune system is responding to the vaccine and are common when receiving vaccines in general, not just this one. Myth number 4, I've already had COVID-19 and I've recovered, so I don't need to get a COVID-19 vaccine when it's available. When someone recovers from a virus and creates their own antibodies, this process is called natural immunity. And unfortunately, there is just not enough information out there yet on how long after infection someone is protected from getting COVID-19 again. Experts have discovered, however, that reinfection of COVID-19 is possible. As of today, January 13th, the day I'm filming this video, the CDC has not made an official recommendation on whether people who have recovered from COVID-19 should be vaccinated. However, individuals who have had COVID-19 may still benefit from a vaccine because we don't know how long immunity lasts after you become better. Myth number 5, I won't need to wear a mask after I get vaccinated for COVID-19. While the vaccine may prevent you from getting sick, it is unknown at this time if you can still carry and transmit the virus to others. Until more is understood about how well the vaccines work, continuing with precautions such as wearing a mask, practicing physical distancing is an important and advised activity. It may take time for everyone who wants a COVID vaccination to get one, so please be patient. Myth number six, the COVID-19 vaccine was developed to control the general population through microchip tracking. Oh man, I've seen this quite a bit in my comments. The fact is, there is no vaccine microchip, and the vaccine will not track people or gather personal information into a database. Our cell phones already do that. I guess one could deduce that this rumor was allegedly, maybe, started by Bill Gates at the Gates Foundation when he mentioned a digital certificate of vaccine records. Bill Gates made a comment in reference to the digital certificates related to efforts to create an open source digital platform with the goal of expanding home-based COVID testing. That being said, absolutely no context of microchips whatsoever. I think some theorists out there may have jumped to that conclusion. Microchips, or any other crazy types of ingredients for that matter, have not been integrated into the development, testing, or distribution of COVID-19 vaccines whatsoever, i.e., there are no microchips in COVID vaccines. Both Pfizer and Moderna have published the ingredient lists for their vaccines. In addition to mRNA, both vaccines contain lipids, fats, that help deliver the mRNA into the cells, and a few other common ingredients that help maintain the pH and the stability of the vaccine. No metals in it at all. Myth number seven, COVID-19 vaccines will alter my DNA. mRNA vaccines work by instructing cells in the body how to make a protein that triggers an immune response. Injecting mRNA into our body will not interact or do anything to our DNA of our cells. It doesn't make it into the nucleus of the cell where our own DNA is. Human cells break down and get rid of the mRNA immediately after they have finished using the instructions. So for the commenters who like to call me GMO Joe, that one's for you. In conclusion, even if you understand the scientific process, please trust medical experts and scientists rather than that creepy, weird, non-verifiable site that you end up reading and sharing on social media. It's crucial to know just how important vaccines are for fighting infectious diseases. With so many rumors floating around, it's definitely okay to still have some questions and concerns. All right, that's been a quick COVID vaccine myth-busting breakdown with me, Dr. Wagner. Do you have any other COVID vaccine myths that you've heard about? Or do you have another medical topic that you'd like me to speak about? Please let me know in the comments. I'd love to hear from you. Also, hit me up on Facebook or Instagram or Twitter as well. I'll be sure to respond there. As always, make sure you subscribe and hit that bell notification. That way you tell YouTube that you want to see more videos like this one. Thank you so much for watching and stay healthy, my friends.